Hey y'all, so I want y'all to get ready with me. I got maybe an hour and a half. I just got out the shower, so next I'm gonna do my makeup. Usually I do my hair then my makeup, but since I'm not a hairstylist, I don't really know what I'm doing. I'm gonna do my makeup first.
Okay y'all, what's up? So I want to do a get ready with me. I don't have that long to get ready, so I'm just gonna start doing what it is I gotta do. My primer. So I'm starting with my orange concealer, LA Girl Pro Concealer, and I'm covering all of my dark spots. I do this before I apply my regular concealer just because I want it to give me more of a flawless finish. Sometimes when you only go in with a regular concealer, those dark spots still come through. So I'm just making sure that everything is the same color. I'm using my finger as well as a brush to blend in that orange concealer. My finger is warm, so it's going to help that product really melt into my skin. I'm using the brush to sort of soak up some of the extra product, and using these two in combination really works for me. After that, I'm going in with my Fenty Girl Concealer, and the color is 400. I'm using that to cover those orange concealer spots. And I'm gonna also use my finger to blend in that concealer. It's always a ring finger because that is the finger that you use that doesn't apply as much pressure. So it'll blend and not remove, basically. After I've blended the concealers on my skin, I'm putting some of that Fenty primer on my eyelids just to make sure that my eyeshadow is going to stay because I am doing an eyeshadow look. I'm going in with my LA Girl Pro Concealer in Fawn and I'm outlining my eyebrows. I did not fill them in yet, but that's because I'm going to go back in later. I don't really want real dramatic brows. I want my eyeshadow to show out the most with this look. I've placed a couple dots of foundation, not concealer, excuse me, on my chin just because I wanted to check to see which color would match me the best. Around the summer, the fall, the winter, you know, your skin changes, so I just want to make sure that the foundation is going to match completely. Now I'm using my white concealer from my Kryolan concealer palette. And I'm placing that down as a base because I'm going to go in with some colors that I want to stand out. I'm not doing anything really dramatic, but I do want these colors to pop and I want them to really have, I want this look to have a gradient effect. So I'm using that finger just to blend everything with that LA Girl concealer because I want it to be smooth. When you're using a white concealer over your regular base concealer and you don't blend it, it can cause harsh lines when adding your eyeshadow, and that's something that you cannot blend once it dries down. So now I'm going in with my eyeshadow. The color is like a orange color, and I'm going to use it as my first shade, And I'm just kind of placing it there. I'm not using a whole lot of product. As you can see, I'm building. To me, building is the best way to do an eyeshadow look, because if you start out and throw a whole bunch of eyeshadow on your eye, it's very easy to get an overpowering look. And before you know it, the eyeshadow is all the way up to your eyebrow. And in the past, I've done that. Right now with this, I'm not trying to do that. So I'm taking my time and using that first color as kind of a base. And it's gonna help me transition a lot easier. Once that color is blended in, I'm using a fluffy brush to do that. Once that color is blended in, I'm going to move on to the next color. This color is more of a red. This color is going to help that orange to really transition. So I'm placing it on top and just blending, 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 blending. When you're blending, you just wanna keep going. You don't wanna stop. Just keep blending. But when you think you're done blending, you still gotta blend some more. So just keep going. That's going to give you the most cleanest, clearest eyeshadow look. And you need to put on primer. You cannot achieve a nice makeup application or eyeshadow application without primer. You need to have primer. You need something for the eyeshadow to stick to. And you need to make sure that, you know, as the day goes on, it doesn't fade. So right now I'm going in with actually my contour shade in the crease, and I'm using that color because I just really want it like a brown, you know, haze. It kind of looks like a dark brown, but it's not. So I'm just blending that in to those other two colors that I placed down, and it's really going to provide a great transition. I love this color, especially on my skin tone, so I thought this would be a great addition. Once I'm done blending, I'm going back into that Krylon palette, but this time instead of using stark white, I'm going to be using more of an ivory color, and I'm just simply making a cut crease. I want this look to be kind of bold and dramatic when I am at the party. I want you to be able to see my eyes from a mile away, from across the room. So I'm placing this down first, and I'm drawing my shape. Excuse my dog, guys. So I'm gonna do this on both sides. Now it's okay if both of these shapes are not completely identical, but you can kind of hide that with the eyeshadow application. So as you can see, I'm only putting it partially, not even like a third of the way across my eye. And then I'm using my brush to just blend that out. Instead of using my finger, I feel as though it would drag too much. So I'm just using that brush just to blend it out into that other eyeshadow, not to hide everything. And then I'm going in my inner corner with a white eyeshadow. This is the part that I want to stand out the most in my makeup look, as it's going to really make it pop. So now that I've placed down that white eyeshadow, I'm going back in with that red color that I used before. And I'm just basically using a flat brush and blending that in, patting and swiping. Then I'm going in with that eyeshadow color. That contour color from my contour palette. And I'm blending that into that red. And as you can see, it's giving like a flawless transition. And I'm going back and forth. That's going to ensure that the brown is blended into the red and the red is blended into the white. I want this to be smooth. I don't want you to be able to tell one color from the next. I want you to be able to see that there's multiple colors, but I don't want you to be able to see where one ends and where one begins. So now I'm going over to this other eye and I'm doing the same thing. But like I said, don't freak out if the two eyes are not identical. This eye on this side was a little bit wider and I couldn't figure it out while I was doing it. Sometimes it's best to step back from your look to really take a look, or take a pause, go get some water, go take a shot, whatever it is you do, and come back and look at it and like, okay. Because when you're looking up close, it's kind of hard to see. Like, I should have stopped there and then blended. But for some reason, I felt like I had to keep going. So I dragged it a little bit too far, but it's okay. Because I took that eyeshadow and I blended it back the best way I could without you really being able to notice. See, like, that's way too far. But it's okay. It all worked out in the end. So now I'm pressing that white eyeshadow color that I used originally. Mind you, I'm going to upload all of, or tag all of the eyeshadow palettes that I use in the description box below, so don't worry. But now I'm going to do the same thing that I did with the other eye. Use that red color to transition. And as you can see, guys, you can tell what I mean when I said I went over a little bit too far. But once I've done, you won't be able to really tell. So I'm blending in that red color, and then once I blend that in to my liking, then I'm going to go back in with that black color, or brown, excuse me, that was my contour, and I'm going to blend them all together. So right now I'm blending the white and the red together, and then I'm going to go in and blend the brown and the red together. Now that everything is blended to my liking, I'm going in with my foundation. I believe this is the Dior foundation in 4N. Again, I'll tag all of these products in the description box below. So I'm using my damp blending sponge to just spread that product all over the place. As you can see, I did not use a whole lot of foundation, which you really don't need unless you need a heavy coverage. But even still, if you need heavy coverage, all you have to do once you place your foundation is let it dry a little bit and then move it around your face, or simply just use a brush instead of a sponge. A sponge tends to soak up more product. So here again, if you want to have more of a fuller coverage, you can use a brush, or you can let the product sit for a little while and get a little bit more tacky before you spread it around, or use a heavier product. MAC usually sells heavy foundation and cream shadow products that you can use. So once I've blended that all in, I'm going to do my eyebrows. I'm using Anastasia Brow Pomade in Ebony, and I'm using the Anastasia Brow Brush. I bought them both at Sephora. I love them both. So as you can see, I'm just doing a quick little outline, and just, you know, giving my eyebrows a little bit of an extra curve. I'm making sure that they're symmetrical, but I didn't want to be extra dramatic this time, so I didn't do too much. Then I'm going into my inner corner with my KKW contour stick. And then I'm going in with my LA Girl Pro Concealer in Ebony, or Espresso, I believe. And I'm using that as a cream contour or a liquid contour, and I'm blending that out. And what that does is, even though I'm using liquid and powder, the liquid gives the powder something to stick to, and it helps to give me a richer, deeper contour that looks a little bit more natural versus just putting powder on top of my makeup, which could initially look a little ashy. It may not look the way I want. So now that I've got my contour cream in place, I'm going to do my LA Girl Concealer in Fawn, and I'm going to place it in all the high points. First, I'm going to chisel out chisel out under my under eye, and I'm going to do the very corners of my mouth, the upper corners underneath my cheeks by my ears, the bridge of my nose, the very middle of my forehead, and around my Cupid's bow on my lip. I'm only putting this tiny amount of concealer right on the corners of my mouth to give the illusion of a chiseled jaw, just to avoid that, what do they call it? The Rick Ross. I don't want to look like I have a beard. So, and I also don't want to use too much product because that could give too much flashback and be white. Sometimes flashback is good, but that's not what I'm looking for. So, here again, I'm going in with that blending sponge. It helps to use a fresh, clean one, but I just flipped the side and used a side that was clean. And I'm just blending out all of that concealer. So, first, what I do is my foundation, and then I do my creams, and then I do my powders. So, I'm going and blending, 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 making sure everything is blended to perfection. That KKW concealer stick, if you let that sit for too long, it is not going anywhere. So, if you want to use that, don't sit it on your face and then go around and do your eyes or something else. You want to move that right away because if not, it's very heavy. It's almost like waterproof. It's sticky. It's very thick. If you don't move it, it's not going anywhere. So, as you can see, I'm going and I'm using that concealer to give my eyeshadow a very sharp line just to clean it up on the outside. You don't have to do that, but I just want it to look very, very clean so that when I apply my eyeliner, it just all goes together. Here I am using my Sephora contour palette and I'm using an angled fluffy brush. And I'm just going over my cream contour that you saw me use it for. As you can see, it gives such a warm glow. It's really helping a lot. And I'm doing this before I use my powder because I'm sorry. I'm doing this before I use my setting powder because I find that I want it underneath the setting powder, and then I'm gonna go on top of the setting powder and do it again. I just want to build it so that it's very rich. You start with a minimal amount and build. You always want to build when you're doing makeup. You never want to start with a whole lot because it's not going to give that effect that you want. So I am using a lot of setting powder here, but the more concentrated amount is in that inner corner. And as you can see, I just continuously keep spreading out, blending out. So I pat it in the inner corner and I blend it out. That's really going to give me that dramatic look that I'm looking for, but it's also not going to be too much to the point where it's like, girl, what is that? You look like a ghost. Because I don't want to look like a ghost. Okay. So once I blend that out, I'm going to go and place powder on my nose, on my forehead, on my chin, and all the areas that I used concealer. Right here, I didn't put a whole lot of concealer, but that's okay. Here again, I'm just using a little powder, so when I go and I blend everything together, it's gonna come off. It's not gonna leave any flashback. I'm using a little bit of contour on my temples, not because I wanna make my temples smaller, but to me, putting it there almost gives me sort of a facelift. So I'm gonna do that. Then I'm moving on to my under eye. I wait until after I do my setting powder to do my under eye because I don't want my under eye to be covered. So I'm using that same set contour powder in that Sephora contour palette to do my under eyes. So now I'm using a cake liner, which is so amazing. And I'm using a thin, long brush, which gives me so much control. With this look, I didn't want to go too crazy with the eyeliner. I simply just wanted to frame my eye. I didn't want it. I didn't even really want you to know that it was there. I just wanted to do a little wing and keep it simple. And as you can see, it just gives the perfect complement to this eyeshadow look. Just all I wanted to do was compliment. So now I'm using my mascara, and this is a Mary Kay mascara, which honestly, guys, I was sleeping on Mary Kay for a long time. Like, they have some good products, but this mascara right here is one of my favorites. It makes my eyelashes look so luxurious. So once I get done using that, I'm going in with my Fenty. This is actually a brow pencil, and I'm using it because it is very light. It is not very pigmented at all. Like I said, it's for your eyebrows. And I'm just using that to outline my lips before I put on my lip gloss. Once I'm done lining my lips, then I'm going to go in with another color lip liner. And this is like also a tan, a light brown. It's definitely lighter than the one that I used, but I wanted it to be like a muted tone. And then I'm going in with my, okay, it's like a cream, it's a nude lip gloss by NYX. What is it called? I got it right here actually. Okay, Intense Butter Gloss in Cookie Butter by NYX, which is like my favorite. And then I'm putting on my lashes, and that's it. And here I go with the finished look at the party, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I love y'all. Stay tuned for another video.